it's time for another one. It's time for another one. This was good.
Spoiler alert. If you ain't seen this already, we about to go in. Honey. Okay.
Don't watch yet. Okay. Well, actually, you can watch. I mean, it's, you know what's gonna happen. That's just kind of like if you can Wikipedia, you'll know what's gonna happen. Just saying. Like, I Wikipedia'd before I watched this, and I was like, damn.
I was going back and forth while I'm watching. I paused it because I'm trying to check the facts. You know, is this legit or did this happen? If you have no idea what we're talking about, we always say we're saying the United States versus Billie Holiday. Well, you see the title, but yeah, that's what we're talking about.
We just jumping right in. This is how we normally do, y'all. We're structuring this as we normally do our conversation. Sam and I, we talk almost every day. And when we're on the phone, we're like, girl, what you been watching? So we figured we would bring this to life. So this is just us, how we normally do, okay? So y'all just follow along, okay? Because this is usual. So yeah, you've seen the title, Wikipedia. Look it up, honey. Ooh, try.
So what'd you think? What's your?
I thought it was fantastic. It was sad as hell. It pissed me off in a lot of aspects of it.
Girl.
But the acting had me like, woo! But really? I love Lee Daniels' productions anyway. Like, and he had a lot of people from Star. Miss Lawrence was in it.
I only know the dude that was the one I said that just, you know what I love. What's the one I said to you? Lawrence. Oh, he's in it. The faith dude, the guy.
Which one?
Remember when I texted you, I said, oh, what's his face is in it?
Yeah. Dude from Everybody Hates Chris.
Yeah.
And his name was Chris in the movie. I think I was like, what kind of shit is it? I'm reading for the role
Let's
of
Chris. Let's make it easy. Let's just call him Chris. Let's make it easy.
But I thought it was fantastic. And Andra Day, mm-hmm. Oh my God. Now, granted, I knew she was talented vocally, but for this to be her first for real role, oh my God. And for her to just win a Golden Globe for Best Actress in a Drama,
girl.
I was like, girl, I believed it. I so believed it. And Trevante Rose with his little fine ass, oh my God, that is a beautiful smiled man. Goodness. And you know I love me some Evan Ross, honey. I was like, ooh, ooh.
Let me pull up the cast.
Mm-mm-mm. He is something to look. He is yummy. You know I like chocolate. Good gracious. Look at that.
Now, when the movie first started, I was like, okay, I can already see it. Men ruled. Men is men. We in charge. Because, boom, she's there to do the interview with I love that little white. What's that little white man name? Leslie Jordan. I love him.
He said, wait. I mean, and he was him. I said, yeah. Leslie Jordan as Leslie Jordan. I was dying. I said, you better have him cast it. But that wig, I could take it. I said, what the hell? Everybody else's hair was good during the movie, except for Leslie's. I said, what the hell? Why they do him like that? Gave him a
George Washington wig.
I said, are we in the 1920s? Are you moving forward? Actually, that was an 1890s wig. I didn't know what was going on. I said, oh, okay. Interesting. Okay.
When I first thought, I was like, okay, I see. Because dude was like, yo, she wasn't saying nothing. And he was like, she like if you pay her money for it. I was like, be a boss. I was like,
And then he was like, cut it off. I said, oh, shit. I said, this going to be it. Okay. I didn't know the tone of the film until, like you said, the first start of it made you go, oh, okay, you could tell the tone is going to be. It was going to be direct in your face.
Yes.
It not filtered at all. And I was here for it. If you're easily offended watching movies, don't watch this because you're not going to make it through. Even till the end, you're going to be like, oh!
It's
not a palatable Lifetime movie. This is not what you're thinking.
No.
This isn't it. This is like, you got to take this like a shot. It's going to be straight. No chaser. It's very, damn. God knows. Like, it was crazy.
I mean, I knew of the Billie Holiday story. It's kind of familiar. It's kind of familiar to a lot of, you know, musicians and singers back in that time, but this is very I've known the story, but just to see this and to see like how She sold out Carnegie Hall, but can't fucking walk in the front door. The fuck is, what fuck is?
That part.
You, Carnegie Hall, and you can't? I mean, I knew about it before, but I don't know, just to, I don't know, seeing it just made it more real, like, I don't know. It's just sad. It's like, but yeah, it's like the story kind of hasn't changed, if you really look at it. I was just about to say,
even for us to be right here, right now, on this type of platform, that's, and granted, she died, was it in 57?
She was 44!
Yeah, it was like, that wasn't that long ago.
I'm like, she was 44. Do you know that, like, all of these powerful Black, like, they died so young?
So young. You know who I thought about watching this? Whitney Houston. I mean, not saying it wasn't, well, shit, it kind of was. Like, the things that you don't know about certain celebrities and what they go through and the addictions that they have, the trauma that they went through. You remember when Jimmy got high for the first time with them?
Yes.
And she said, just go with it. Let it go.
And she said, I'm shocked that he took it. I was like,
that part. I said, oh, that's how I knew he was falling deep. Yeah. When he was like, okay, I'm gonna take this ride with you because I'm not rolling with everybody else. I got you. And then that was powerful, a scene, because he could figure out who she was and just a little glimpse, because sometimes you don't know somebody's story. All the time we try to say, why did he do that? Oh Lord, she did heroin or she did cocaine. And you don't know people's story. Not that that gives them a pass, right, but at the same time, it's like, you don't know.
You don't know.
You have no idea. Especially like, during that time, oh my God, I could only imagine.
It's like so much was going on this, so much was going on this movie. Okay,
she it was.
Came, you it was know, the story they're saying, you know, she, the background she came up to, and I also read about it, grew up in like in a brothel, and she,
yes,
like, her, I believe that she used to do, run sex, you know, do, work in the sex field, whatever.
Yeah.
And so I can kind of understand why she is the way with she, the, and the men that she's chosen in her life.
Because that's what she saw growing up. Oh, she God. To see her own mother, how that was. When she was like, hey girl, you either that's gonna stay with us, get to work, or get out. We ain't got room. And it's like, back then, they had to survive. Shit, even now you have to survive.
Right.
But back then, you didn't have a choice. Sorry. Like a lot of times, they were just sent away. Because the mom had to do work or working for white people or whatever. And it's right. Like, hey, I gotta take care of other people's kids. I can't take care of you either. Or I got to take care of myself. So, it was just, oh, and even during their sex scene.
Which one?
They were like, oh, yeah. with Jimmy. When
she's coming, take your clothes off.
Yeah, when she's like, take your clothes off. And she was like, ah, and he was like, uh-uh. And then when he was getting ready to kiss her, she was like, oh, that's powerful to me.
Because she was like, what the fuck?
You to love the trusting. And that fucked with her. But then she was falling in love, and then she was like, oh, hell no. Nope, I can't trust nobody. Cannot trust them. I'll go back to the one that, you know, is going to screw me over.
Understand. Oh my God,
always plays a fuck nigga. What is that dude's name? But either way, he was in P-Valley recently. And he played, no, that wasn't him. Was he in P-Valley? What movie was he in recently that I saw? That made me go,
Rob, what are we talking, Rob Morgan?
Yeah.
Rob Morgan. Yeah.
What was he in recently that made me go, it wasn't Queen Sugar, it was something.
But yeah, he annoyed the hell out of me.
Oh, he's so annoying.
When he came in that scene where it was, I think she had just finished performing or something, and he comes in and hits her like, oh, you're gonna steal my money. I was like, oh.
And then he was like, you can have the bitch. I was like, look.
He beat her like a man. Kicked her up. I'm like, oh. But she was like still going after, and her friend was put like, stop, stop. I'm like.
Oh my God, and the friend. Oh my God. I was like, even till the end, it was like, oh my God. It was just crazy.
She a true friend though. That friend, she a true friend. Friend.
Yeah.
Because that could have been me. I'm sorry.
Child.
It could be me. First, I mean, yo, I cracked up at the scene when it's at the church. I knew it was her dog that died. I knew it was the dog.
I didn't know. But then, when my dad passed, she was like, yeah, he'd sit in my lap all the time. I said, this is a damn dog. She took it. And they all cried, and he like, are you lost? What?
He didn't know what to say. Like,
because back then, they was like, what? But I was like, is she gonna love her animals? Yes.
Our friend was like, see how you should have like climb on your, eat your stuff off your plate. But then when they was out to go out to eat and they was waiting to be seated, and they was called to some dude, and you know, the friend told her that's a bad news, you know, bad news.
Yeah.
Oh, well, and then she comes over, invite you dinner. You gonna leave her? Yeah. You don't wanna eat? No. I was like, oh no.
She was like, you don't wanna eat with us, do you? I'll see you back at the outside. But that showed, you know, that she had so many dimensions to her. Even when she left the band, when they broke down.
I was like, she leaving them?
And they were like, yo, that's fucked up. Bitch. That was like, it is fucked up.
I was shocked. Like, she really gonna leave them there?
Oh my God, I was just den, okay? But what, the best part, not the best part, but another scene that made me go, was at the end when they wanted to get her
her confession.
Yeah,
and she's like, "Kiss my black
shit. You can suck my black ass." I was dying.
I didn't expect that.
But they said, I watched some documentary today, and I'll send it to you. It was the BBC documentary, and it had people who actually knew her, because I don't like them documentaries where people don't know them. And she was like, he said she basically did do that. She was like, this is it. They can kiss my ass. I was like,
what she got to lose, yo? What she got to lose?
She's on her deathbed. She was like, fuck this. I ain't give me a shit.
You see, they handcuffed her to the bed. I'm like, where's she going?
And that was true life.
Where's she going?
Like, where was she gonna go?
Where's she going?
But it's like how ruthless and how much they did not care. And old dude at the end, I love when they put this shit at the end so we know exactly what happened.
Oh,
baby boy was getting all types of merits and awards for his fuck shit. And it was like, what?
But you notice that, again, it could come up to today.
Yeah.
The woman is the one rooting for the black man. Uh-huh. Hosting and holding up the black man. Uh-huh. But the black man ain't pushing that strong. But then trying to push down the black woman who here trying to push you up. But you're trying to kill me in the midst, but I'm trying to hold you up. I can't.
And granted, this was like three times she let this nigga back in.
I was like, what the
fuck? And all of them are looking at her like, are you crazy?
He done set you up.
And then at the end, you want to fall in love. Oh, hell no. And to be honest, that was karma for him at the end.
Oh.
Like, you know how it is, baby. I got to go. I'ma see you, Soldier Boy. Peace out. Soldier Boy, tell him. He was basically like, bye. You be all right. It don't feel good, does it? Got to go.
It's
but the way she died at the end, oh my God.
You see, she went out there and performed when she was beat up, how they had to wrap her body up. She still went and performed.
And the way, oh my God, and the tears when she was wrapping her up to like, oh my God.
You see, but that's the black woman. Do all the shit, we still.
Get your ass up there and perform. Today, get your ass up there and perform.
No matter what you're going through, no, you're a strong black woman. Get up there
and perform. The crazy thing is not just get up there, perform. Well, tap dance, do it all, because we're seen as the quintessential woman. Even this month, it is Women's History Month. I'm sitting like, we just get a month. It's about like Black History. It should be Women's History every day. That's why I don't really, I really love Black History Month and, you know, Women's History. But there's certain things that I don't feel like I just need to focus 1 month on. Like, no. But even her story, it's kind of like, ooh, I was watching some interviews, because whenever I watch a movie and it's for real, I got to go all the way and look at everything. Mm. I was watching some interviews with Andra, and she was basically saying how she lost 40 pounds to do this movie.
Because she lost weight because of the cirrhosis, yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. She said she had started smoking cigarettes because she doesn't smoke, so it could be believable. She said she didn't drink, but she started drinking gin heavily just to feel like her and embody it. I was like, damn. She was like, nah, I don't really have sex like that. And I'm guessing, yeah, don't be fucking around just to know how to fuck. But at the same time, it was like she wanted to be her.
Right.
She wanted to be that character.
She played that role.
And it was like, girl, I believe it. She said, I cut my hair off. I just, whatever Lee wanted me to do to embody this character, she said, I did it. And like I said, you get up there mm-hmm. and you perform, because he didn't want her to be Billie Holiday because she had never acted. But imagine if he didn't cast her.
True.
So again, we're expected to do the most, perform. Yeah. And look at her performing, doing it. But at the same time, even it's a testament to her too. It's like,
that's a lot to go through for that part.
It's a lot to do, but she showed up. She performed. She did whatever he asked her to do so that she could be, you know.
Girl, that's, wow. When she went from jail to Carnegie Hall, I like the way they did that. She went from the jail to Carnegie mm-hmm. Hall.
Yeah. The yeah. transitions were really good in the film.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, oh, the men in this movie just pissed me off.
Pissed yes.
off. Because they took it for granted because she's the talent. Yes. You just around collecting the money. What? She wasn't paying. I don't think she was paying. She wasn't paying the musicians. Because you know she was counting down that money when the dude came in there. Mm-hmm. And I was like, couldn't be me.
Child, I'd be like, you know what, Villa, I love you, girl, but you know, yeah. And even at that time, it wasn't like it is now, of course, but it was just still a lot. Even when you watch What's Love Got to Do With It, I don't watch that very often. Why? Because it's the same format.
Mm-hmm.
Even Lady Sings the Blues, because they didn't do it directly like that, because that was based off of Billie Holiday's life. But okay. Those movies, it's like, it's the same format. Same format. Over, even today. Same format.
Same thing. And I'm like, bruh. It was very good. There's some like when they it was DEA now. What were they called? Whatever. The DEA now. But when every time they said the word nigga, I was like, fuck.
Even when we watched Judas and the Black Messiah.
Yeah, it just...
Sometimes it makes it, ooh, I'd be like, ooh.
You know what what I think? The people who act in those roles, I don't know. I just kind of think like, what do they feel inside? Like, it's like, okay, this is my past. I can say the word.
How do you feel afterwards? Do you like, do you have to go to therapy? Like, or are you just going back with your family and y'all just chopping it up? Like, it makes me, I don't know.
We think like, is it?
Because the roles that we have,
But it was very, 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 very believable. Very believable.
Oh yeah, for sure. It was a great adaptation. I believed it. I never for once looked at this film and said, what? I was just into it the whole time. And it was like you were rooting for her. Mm-hmm. You were rooting in a lot of the scenes. And then in a lot of the scenes, I was just like, girl. I get it. I get it. But it was just a lot.
The heroin scenes are hard.
Very hard for me to watch. I cringed a lot of the time on that.
Like to see, again, you saw the tracks in her arm. And you see the dude who they were, when I read on it, they were married. I didn't know they were married. I didn't, you know, reading up on it. But like you see where he shot up and just fell into the bed. He licked the blood. Like, oh!
And he was just like, you know, and then it was like, this is normal. What you talking about? And then when he was like, y'all just want to arrest niggas for having a good time. You can't stand to see us happy and having a good time. I'm like, y'all ain't happy. How do you believe y'all are happy? That ain't nothing to be happy about.
I was wondering, like, I want to go and look at real, like, actual footage. I've seen snippets of mm-hmm. but it seemed like she was drunk every time she... I don't know. I'm like, high or drunk? It's like,
or at least under the influence. Yes. Because there were a lot of the times where she was like, do you remember when she was like, yeah, I was high during this performance because it was a lot of pressure on me. And it was kind of like, that's how she felt. Like, hey, I have to be under something to perform.
And that's
to get up here and perform with that amount of pressure every night and to be scared because I don't know if the feds gonna come in and arrest me. Like, I don't know what to do. So that was her resort. And I guess for a long time, that's what she had to do to just survive and to be normal in her eyes.
It's
which
sad.
Is really sad.
It's mm-hmm. sad. It's sad, and it's good to know that such people existed in such a time. You know, that's the part that I powerful. And it's, you know, that she didn't originally write the song and didn't do the research. It was a poem that someone had written and transferred over. Yes. It was wasn't originally her. It was a poem that someone had written, you know, for the same reason, of course, but it transferred or, you know, got to her and then became this song, which I didn't know. That's something I learned today.
Okay.
The scene when she went to the, when she heard the child crying.
Yes.
And went back there and to see, I was like, okay, I'm done.
And then to see that whole whirlwind. She was getting ready to get high and then they stopped her and then it was like, okay, let's go. And then, it was a roller coaster. Just imagine at that time how Black people felt and still feel today. It's a roller coaster every single day. I was even watching that, like, to hear that that act has still not been passed.
I just
watched from the end of the movie when it said as of 2020. So maybe it had.
Okay, on February 26th, the House passed the revised version of the Emmett Till Anti-Lynching Act by a vote.
Even that was recently.
Recent. That's crazy that's something.
That's what made me go, what? Child, we still got so much work to do.
But what But I'm glad that they're coming out with a lot more of movies like this because back in my day, it was only like films of Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, and Kunta Kinte. What's the name of that movie?
Roots.
Roots. Those are the only things. Those are like movies. It wasn't all of these. All of these movies. It wasn't that. That's all you had back then. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X.
It was the same for me growing up. I grew up in the 90s. But all that was, of course, it was a lot of animation and shit like that. It wasn't no documentaries and docuseries. I mean, they did What's Love Got to Do With It, The Temptation, shit like that. They didn't really have, like, not saying these things didn't have meaning, because they did.
Yeah.
I'm just saying it was still a little made for TV.
Hollywood,
not too in your face, okay? Mm-hmm. So now, we're just now getting that. We're just now seeing films that make you go, shit.
Yeah.
What? This is an outrage. And it's like, okay. But there's so many stories that we don't know about so many people in that film that were real life people.
Yes.
So much shit we did not know about. Nope. I didn't know about a lot of this stuff. And that's the thing. If it's not in front of people's eyeballs, just like her winning a Golden Globe, it was like, now so many more people are going to watch this aren't us.
Right.
And I bet I don't know how they're going to watch. Are they going to be like, oh my God, that was crazy. Did you see that? The U.S. versus, oh my God, it was, girl, you got to watch it. Like, no, they ain't going to say that. They're going to be like, damn. God, that would not be something they tell their friends to watch. We should all get a rack, come around and watch this.
Netflix and chill. Let's do this. Get
Netflix and chill to that. That you will be Netflix and depressed. I really needed to decompress after watching that movie. I was like, my spirit, it was just heavy. I was like, oh my God. I can't watch like them 12 Years of Slave movies and shit like that.
But think that it's hilarious. Yeah. Isn't that hilarious? I'm like, really? You on your deathbed with cirrhosis? I mean, I know you're dying. I know you're going out, but you're still smoking?
Lisa, to the death. To the death. I saw that too. I was like, did anybody tell her no? It seemed like she wasn't the one that you tell no, because she ain't gonna listen. She seemed like she was one of the ones, I'm gonna have my
what I want. I was like, She just a puffing away in the bed. You can't even.
BD. But anyway, mind your business. She was just sitting there like, man, go on, polish my nails for me. Like, it was like, what? It's
going on. I was like, bro.
She was hurt to the end, till the end. I had a whole new respect.
So, I'm not trying to be funny. But look at the end of the movie, her best friend, she had a patch on no more. What, she got an eyeball during the whole trip? Did she get a fake eye?
Yeah, she had a blonde and she was ready to go, honey.
Oh, okay.
I want to be attached with this blind wig. I want to be doing it, honey. Boom. Here we go. Here it is. Bam. Because I know, and being in the field of ophthalmology, I don't think they did prosthetics. And, well, yes, back, they did. Back then. Just didn't have, I don't know. And there's different things that happen with the eye. So I don't know if she had like an ulcer that was deteriorated. I have no idea what was going on with her. And maybe she did just have a blue eye. We didn't see up close. Some people have different colored irises. I don't know. Maybe that just was looked at as like weird and strange back then. I don't know what her little deal was. They never went back in her past, so I can't tell you that. It didn't seem like she was cockeyed or that like
no,
that.
No, I was like, okay, all of a sudden she ain't got no.
He was like, you go from patch to nothing.
Yeah, I'm like, okay.
Live your best life, girl. I don't know. But ultimately, I thought it was good.
Excellent, yeah. Would you watch it again? No.
No, I'm good. I'm good. I told my mom, I'll play it for you. I'll turn it on in your room. Yeah, I don't need to watch it. She was like, we can watch it together. I said, no, girl, I don't watch it. That was a good 2 hours of my life. Yeah. That is heavy. You can tell to watch it. I can't watch those type of films over and over and over again. I cannot.
No. It just, I don't want to be upset at the people.
Correct. It just took me this long to dial down.
Yeah, this one just...
No. Mm-mm. But y'all should watch it, though. Please watch it if you haven't already.
Definitely.
Please.
Definitely. Yeah, that's all I got on this one.
That's all I got for it, too. I thought it was really good. Down below in the comments, let us know what you thought about this movie. It's on Hulu, if you don't know where it is by chance. But definitely check it out. Let us know what you would like us to review next, because we look at all the streaming platforms. Everything.
Everything.
Okay, so post it down below. Thank y'all so much for watching, and we'll see y'all in the next one. Peace out, y'all.
We out.